Human body has two kidneys. The function of the kidneys is to excrete the waste products, the nitrogenous waste products, maintain the water balance. Two hormones, erythropoietin for hemoglobin synthesis, vitamin D for bone health, and also it manages the acid balance of the body. When the function of the both kidneys fall below 10% is the time when we think about dialysis. The indications for dialysis are when there are excess water in the body, that is fluid overload, when there is excess in the anions like potassium, hyperkalemia, when there is excess acid in the body, metabolic acidosis, when the uremic toxins affect the brain, that is uremic encephalopathy, or when it affects the heart, that is uremic pericarditis. There are two types of dialysis. One is hemodialysis and the other is peritoneal dialysis. Hemodialysis is done when the blood is taken out of the body through the temporary or permanent dialysis catheter or AV fistula, and that blood is purified through a dialysis filter and returned back to the body. Peritoneal dialysis is done by administrating dialysate fluid into the peritoneal cavity, that is your own abdominal cavity, and it is purified across the peritoneal membrane. The hemodialysis is done in a hemodialysis unit, and peritoneal dialysis can be done at home by the patient or the attender. There are some myths about dialysis. First question the patient asks is whether the same blood is being given back to him. During dialysis, the patient's blood is taken out into the filter and the same blood is returned back to him. Second question commonly asked is whether once dialysis is started, whether it can be stopped. Dialysis once started in acute cases like acute poisoning, acute snake bite, heart attack related renal dysfunction, or temporary renal dysfunction, and in these cases, once you start dialysis, we can consider to stop once the renal function improves. So it's not necessary that once you start dialysis, you cannot stop. But in chronic cases where the renal function is already deteriorated to less than 10% from both the kidneys, we need to do dialysis on a regular basis till the patient gets transplanted. Dialysis is done either twice or thrice a week depending on patient's urine output and blood parameters. VPS Lakeshore does more than 1000 sessions of dialysis per month. The quality and the care is very good. There is one new technique of continuous renal replacement therapy which has been used in the ICU for dialyzing patients who are very critical and hemodynamically unstable. So we can do bedside dialysis next to the patient and monitor the patient. Hence, stitch in time saves 9. Good quality dialysis, good quality health.